Hello everyone, welcome to my online channel, The Palm Leaf. This is the third video in the data analytics and visualization series. In the previous video, we had looked at an introduction to ggplot and we had seen how to draw a catplot using a simple line of code. In this video, what we are going to try and achieve is we'll see how to plot a violin plot. It's a fairly new kind of a plot. If you are only accustomed to Excel-based plots, we don't see violin plots out of Excel. So it's going to be an interesting plot for us to look at. And the reason why I wanted to begin with a violin plot is just to show that we could both look at correlation and distribution in the same plot. And it is fairly simple as well. So let's begin. So before I show you the violin plot, which is there in the bottom right box of your screen, we just need to understand how a violin plot should be read. So let's assume that we'll get to this point, we'll get to this plot at some point in this video or in the next video. What you can see here is on the x-axis, you've got a categorical variable. Here it is class, and we have looked at the MPG database earlier, right? It's different types of cars. You can have pickup vans, SUVs, two-seaters, so on and so forth. And on the y-axis, you have got the highway miles per gallon, which essentially talks about mileage, right, of cars, of different types of cars on highways. So what you can see here is if you just look at the first one, right, the pickup van or pickup trucks, you can see that the plot is in the shape of a violin, and the width of that violin is actually the number of data points or observations for the pickup class. So you will see that maybe a lot of observations is actually present somewhere just below 20 miles per gallon, right? Similarly, if you look at the subcompact class, you can see that the highway miles per gallon, the range for the highway miles per gallon is fairly wide, right? It goes right from 20 to above 40. Right, and then another observation is that pickup vans and SUVs have got low or relatively low mileage compared to subcompact and compact classes. Right, so the violin class gives you these two things: it gives you correlation and it gives you the kind of distribution within a particular categorical variable against a numerical variable. Right, now let's try and plot some of the basic violin plots, and then we will get to this final graph. Right, so the objective of this video is just so that we can understand how we can comfortably draw the violin plot. Before that, just a quick recap of how the MPG database is. This is a database which is already available in ggplot. So when you run the library ggplot argument, it's already catered to that. Right. So as you can see, we are looking at the class column here, the class variable here, which has got all these different types of car types. And we are going to look at the highway miles per gallon. We're trying to plot a categorical variable class against a numerical variable HWY and see how the distribution is, right? To begin with, we'll simply reuse the earlier ggplot syntax. We'll call the data set, which is MPG, and we'll call the aesthetics within the ggplot. X-axis is the categorical variable and y-axis is the numerical variable. So this is pretty much same as what we had seen in video 2, where we had plotted the geom, the scatter plot using geom point. Now, instead of geom point, what we'll use is geom violin. So this is the benefit and the flexibility that R provides. You don't really need to change columns as in Excel sheet. You can simply call on the plot that is required, and then R does that for you, right? So let me just press Control Enter since I have selected the line. So this is the basic violin plot here, what you see on your screen, right? Now because this is extremely bland, let's try and add some colors into it so that it starts looking good, right? In the next column, in the next in line number 32, what we see is I have added a geom jitter. This is equivalent to a geom point, and in subsequent videos I'll cater to how geom jitter works, but this line of code will help us understand how the distribution or how the number of observations are. So I mean, and again, to our advantage, you can actually have multiple plots on the same grid, right? So what you see in the background is a violin plot, and all the dots that you see are from geom jitter. Now, what geom jitter, how geom jitter is different from geom point is that if you have overlapping data sets, geom point won't show it, right? And geom jitter actually spreads those points out evenly, so that you can actually see the number of observations. So the reason why I used geom jitter along with geom violin is just to show you how the width of the violin depends upon the number of observations on the numerical axis. Right, so if you look at the y-axis, this is highway miles per gallon, and you can see if you look at the pickup class, you can see that from right closer to the x-axis, you see that there are 3 points, right? And which signifies the small width that a pickup starts with, and then it starts to fade, and then it starts accumulating more width as soon as the observations begin to increase, and towards maybe closer to 18 or 17 miles per gallon, you see most of the observations here, and then it begins to fade down, right? Similarly, if you look at the subcompact class, it's got a super wide range, and it's got few observations right about 25 miles per gallon, and then it kind of fades towards the end, right? So this is how I hope with these two plots overlapping each other, it's fairly easy to understand how what geom violin stands for, and how geom jitter can be used along with geom violin just to prove that the width of the violin actually represents the number of the glass, right? Hope that is fairly simple. Now, just to spice this up, we'll try and plot the same violin plot, but we'll try and fill colors based on what we have kept in the x-axis. So in the x-axis we have kept glass. We'll try and fill. And so there's a difference between using the function fill and using the function col, right? Col usually stands for outline, and fill stands for anything that has to be filled within a shape. So if we so I'll just run this code and show you first, and then we'll make subtle changes just to understand how it's happening. So this is the graph that we started off with, right? So what is happening here is the moment you use fill and color, both the outline and the color and the space within the plot is actually filled per class type. So pickup has a separate color, SUV has a separate color, the two-seater has a separate color, so on and so forth, right? Now, if we want to play around with this, you can actually not have the col function. You can simply put fill is equal to class, and in this case you will see a subtle difference, and the subtle difference is the outline is colored in black, while whatever is being filled inside is per the class type, right? So it's entirely up to us on how we want to find it, but this can be easily handled. I mean, color coding, and in one of the subsequent videos I will address all the different types of themes that we can use in ggplot, all the different types of ways we can label, we can modify colors, shapes and sizes, just from a cosmetic perspective. So that is a subsequent video which I'm planning, right? Just before we close, I just wanted to cover one more aspect. So when we started off, we said that a violin graph usually has a categorical variable on the x-axis and a numerical variable on the y-axis. Now, let's say we've got a numerical variable. So in this case, if you look at the MPG database, you see that there is a column called as CYL, which stands for number of cylinders. The number of cylinders are, I think, 4 or 5 different types. So cylinders, there can be 4 cylinders, 6 cylinders, 8 cylinders, or 12 cylinders, if I'm right. So if you want to use cylinders in your x-axis, you can actually do that in R. The only thing is that you have to convert it into something called as a factor, and that is very easily done. You just have to write factor parenthesis a numerical class variable, in this case cylinder, CYL. Right? The moment you do this, it automatically converts CYL into a categorical class, right? And you can use the violin graph for this. So wherever we had in the previous line, in line 35, wherever we have mentioned x is equal to class, we just have to say x is equal to factor of CYL, right? That acts as your categorical class. We are taking the CTY column here, which is city miles per gallon, similar to the highway miles per gallon, and then we are running the GM violin code, right? The moment you do that, what you can see is it automatically understands or takes this to be the x-axis to be a categorical variable, and you can actually see those cars with four cylinders. They have got a wide range from 15 to 35. Those cars with five cylinders are usually around 20 miles per hour in cities, and so on and so forth. So again, in this graph, we could easily see that there is a negative correlation between the number of cylinders and mileage of class, right? There are a few more aspects to be covered in the violin graph, which I will cover in the next video. Hope to see you. I hope this was fairly okay. Hope to see you in the next video. Thank you very much for watching.